As rescue operations continue to retrieve the trapped Timmanna continue, his father has pleaded that they be stopped. But what do politicians have to say about this? Here's the report. Out there in Sulikere, the mood is absolutely sad. Hopes are diminishing, but the efforts are only continuing. In fact, Timmanna's father himself has become very pessimistic. This morning, he is said to have pleaded not to carry on with the operations, fearing his sugarcane field getting spoiled. But leaders from across parties reacted rather cautiously.
Even though ಇದು ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮವಾಗಿರತಕ್ಕಂತ ವಿಚಾರ ಇದು ಅವರ ತಂದೆ ಏನು ಒಂದು ನಿಜವಾದ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತಗೋತಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಆಧರಿಸಿ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಮುಂದೆ ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ
ಸರ್ ಈಗ ಅವರು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಗ್ರಾಮಸ್ಥರು ಕೂಡ ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ತಗೊಂಡಿವೆ
ಯಾರು ಅದು ಹೇಳಿದಾರೆ
ಗ್ರಾಮಸ್ಥರು
ಗ್ರಾಮಸ್ಥರ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೆಳಿಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿರ್ಬೋದು ಇವಾಗ ನಾನು ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಸ್ವತಃ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನನಗೆ ನೀವು ನಾನು ಬಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನಾನು ನಿನ್ನೆ ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದೆ ಅದು ಇದು ಯಾವುದೇ ವಿಚಾರ ಆಗಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇವ್ರು ಸ್ಥಗಿತಗೊಳಿಸಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಮಗೆ ಸುದ್ದಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಾನು ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ವಿಚಾರ ಏನಿದೆ ನನ್ನ ಜಮೀನು ಹಾಳಾಗಬಾರ್ದು ಅದನ್ನ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಈಗ ಏನೋ ಈಗ ಮನಿ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಏನೋ ಬರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ರೋಬೋಟ್ ಅಂತ ರೋಬೋಟ್ ಮೂಲಕ ತೆಗಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ವಿಚಾರ
SR Patil, District in Charge Minister, who has been overseeing rescue operations, seemed to be considerate with the father.
ಅವರು ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕವಾದಂತಹ ವಿಚಾರಗಳಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅವರು ಭವಿಷ್ಯತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಒಂದು 3 ಲಕ್ಷ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಮೀಟರ್ದಷ್ಟು ಮಣ್ಣು ನಾವು ಹೊರತೆಗೆಯೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ದೊಡ್ಡದಾದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಕೆರೆ ನಿರ್ಮಾಣ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದೇ ಮಣ್ಣನ್ನು ಉಳಿದ ಜಮೀನಲ್ಲೇನೆ ಹಾಕಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಗುಡ್ಡ ನಿರ್ಮಾಣ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ಕಡೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆರೆ ಒಂದು ಕಡೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಗುಡ್ಡ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರು ಭವಿಷ್ಯತ್ತಿನ ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯಿಂದ ಆ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿರ್ಬೋದು ಆದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಚರಣೆ ಆ ಮಗುನ ಹೊರತೆಗುವಂಥ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಚರಣೆ ಆ ಮಗು ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಅಪೇಕ್ಷೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ದೇವರಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಮಗು ಜೀವಂತವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಗೆ ಬರಲಿ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ವಿಚಾರ
Women and Child Welfare Minister Umashree too echoed the same views.
ನಮಗೆ ಮಗು ಉಳಿಬಹುದು ಉಳಿಸೋಣ ಅನ್ನುವಂತಹ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನದಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾಡಳಿತ ಕೈ ಹಚ್ಚಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮಗಳ ಮೂಲಕವಾಗಿ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಬೇಡಿಕೆ ಆತನಿಂದ ಬಂದಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಈ ಒಂದು ಬೇಡಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಾನ್ಯ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಉಸ್ತುವಾರಿ ಸಚಿವರು ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳು ನಾವು ಶಾಸಕರು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಮೇಲ್ಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳಿಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳು ನಮಗೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸ
ಆತನ ಆತಂಕ ಇರೋದು ಜಮೀನು ಹಾಳಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ವಾಪಸ್ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋಂತು ಇರಬಹುದು ಆದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ
ಅದನ್ನೇ ತಾವ್ ಹೇಳಿ ನಂಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಆತನ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ್ಲೂ ಸಹಿತ ಆತ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದನು ಕೂಡ ಅದನ್ನ ಬಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣನೇ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಮಾನ್ಯ ಸಚಿವರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಮತ್ತು ಶಾಸಕರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾನೆ
ಅದು ಚರ್ಚೆ
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆ ಅದರಿಂದ ಅದು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಾನು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದೆ
When Chief Minister Siddaramaiah's views were sought, this is what he had to say.
ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ SR ಪಾಟೀಲ್ರಿಗೆ ನೇಮಿಸಿದೀವಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಸವಲತ್ತುಗಳು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅವ್ರು ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರು ಅವರು ಮಾನಿಟರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರಮಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಅದನ್ನು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ತೆಗಿಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸವಲತ್ತುಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ SR ಪಾಟೀಲ್ರಿಗೆ ನೇಮಿಸಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅವರು ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ
Well, the father has asked the operations to be halted, but they are going on. We only hope that the boy Timmanna is retrieved as soon as possible, alive. Harish, News 9, Bagalkot. Rescue operations to retrieve the trapped Timmanna are in full swing for the third consecutive today. And today, rain, rock and mud played spoiled sport. Here's the report.
The rescue operations went on for the third consecutive day. First, it was farmer from Mandya, Manje Gowda, who tried his hand at trying to retrieve the trapped child. But again, it was not an easy job.
ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಚರಣೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ನ ರೋಬೋಟ್ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಲ್ಲು ಅಡ್ಡಾಗಿದ್ದು, ಆ ನಂತರ ನಾವು ಮಣ್ಣು ಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು, ಮಣ್ಣು ಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಮಗುವಿನ ಚಲನವಲನ ಆಗಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಏನು ಯಾವುದು ತಿಳಿತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಮಣ್ಣು ಆ ಕೈನ ಹಿಡಿದು ಅಥವಾ ಮೇಲೆತ್ತ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಚರಣೆಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ತೊಂದರೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಇವ ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಇವತ್ತು ನೈಟು ಆ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಯೂಮ್ನ ಬಳಸಿ ಮಣ್ಣನ್ನು ಮೇಲೆತ್ತುವಂಥ ಕಾರ್ಯನ ಕೈಗೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಆ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಿಷನ್ ಬಂದು ಅದು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆ ನಂತರ ತಿರುಗಿ ಸ್ಥಗಿತಗೊಳಿಸಿ ತಿರುಗಿ 3 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಯೂಮ್ನ ಕರೆಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದರಿಂದ ಅದ್ರ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಚರಣೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ.
Well, what made matters worse was heavy rain. Media men were cleared. A lot of security was in place.
40 hours since the 6-year-old boy fell into this borewell, and the rescue operation is still going on. And the excavation work, the Herculean task of digging and reaching this boy at a depth of around 160 feet is still going on. In the meanwhile, the other rescue work over there using the robot bought by Manjegowda from Mandya has been stopped. There has been no major headway made by that robot. We are also told that Manikantan from Tamil Nadu too is on his way over here to Bagalkot. In the meanwhile, the excavation work is still on. There are official figures stating that somewhere around 60 feet is what they have achieved. But there are other speculations going on that it might be around 80 to 90 feet. Look at the Herculean task. Roughly around 4 to 5 JCBs are working together and trying to ensure that they can reach this depth as soon as possible. What they have to do is they have to build a ramp and then reach this boy, and it will take a good 4 to 5 days is what we were told yesterday. In the meanwhile, the other major concern over here for this excavation work are the high tension wires that are running on the other side. The ramp will have to go further. It is a 500 meter ramp. So this high tension wire is also a cause of concern, and the rescue officials are speaking to the officials from the ESCOMs over here to try and understand if has there been any underground cable that is there, or will this be in any way hampering the rescue operation. In the meanwhile, the land has been cleared to dump the soil that is excavated and make sure that the soil doesn't cave in once the rescue work starts. Well, this is as far as the rescue operation. The oxygen is still being pumped. An ambulance is on the standby, but with each passing minute, the hope is fading.
Later in the day, the suction pump was used to clear mud that had collected on the boy's body. Meanwhile, Manikandan, the robot expert who is expected to lend his help in the rescue operations, was later in the evening. But unfortunately, he lost his way to Bagalkot and headed to Haveri. So he had to be rerouted to Bagalkot, which meant the entire team to reach the spot of the happening would only take more time. Earlier in the day, Minister for Women and Child Welfare, Umashri, reiterated that the district administration must cooperate fully in tragedies like this.
When this kind of an incident occurs, you know, the district administration will take care of all the thing, and all the officers will come together and they will definitely they do it. And the instructions has been given by the government that this should not be happen, and the district administration should go for the awareness to create in the people, and that is in some district it's already started, and some district they are going to be taken up.
Well, the rescue operations are in full swing, but hopes only seem to be dimming about Timmanna's survival. Harish Upadhyay from Bagalkot for News 9.
The Israeli army and Hamas finally seem to have ended the month-long violence at the Gaza Strip. Just 3 days after violating ceasefire, both sides have agreed to a new truce. Here's the report.
After violating the 72-hour ceasefire truce on Friday, the Israeli army and Hamas began yet another 72-hour ceasefire today. Now that the ceasefire has begun, Israel has withdrawn their troops completely from the Gaza Strip. The ceasefire was mediated by Egypt. Egypt's contacts with relevant parties have achieved a commitment for a 72-hour truce in Gaza and an agreement for the rest of the relevant delegations to come to Cairo to conduct further negotiations. The Israel Defense Forces will be redeployed in defensive positions outside the Gaza Strip, and we will maintain those defensive positions. The ceasefire began at around 8 this morning. Hamas fired around 17 rockets at the Israeli army just minutes before starting the ceasefire. 11 of them hit and 6 were intercepted by the Iron Dome over the area of Gush Dan, Ashdod and Be'er Sheva. The Israeli army also fired back. The exchange of fire did not result in the loss of life to civilians or troops. Why did Israel withdraw their troops? The decision came as the Israeli troops seemed to have completed their main mission. Their main aim was to destroy the cross-border tunnels dug by Palestinian guerrillas to attack Israel. The Israeli army had blown several such tunnels, which included 32 underground infiltration passages and dozens of access shafts. Thousands of innocent people, including children, were killed in the month-long violence between the Hamas and Israel that began on July 8th. A News 9 report.